Hi, so welcome to this question here. So this is very similar to the one before this, where you're trying to figure out what happened if it's a negative sign in the front or inside a radical, but this time the root number is a 3, which is an odd number, okay? So grab your calculator, if you punch in cube root of 27, you should get the answer that just says 3, okay? Which is nice and easy. Now, if there is a negative sign in the front of the radical, now, you want to treat that negative 1 like that in the front of the radical. And you still go ahead and use your calculator or do your own work on a paper and figure out cube root of 27, which is going to give you 3, okay? So at the end, you're just going to get negative 3, okay? Coming down to the very last question right here. It's a cube root of negative 27. Now, if you remember, we don't square root any negative numbers because it will give it no solution, right? But this time you're not doing square root, you're doing cube root. So, if you're doing the cube root, the negative just comes out from the radical sign and you still go ahead and figure out the 27 separately from the negative sign. Okay, it's a little shortcut. So you still get a 3. So the answer is just a negative 3. Now, does this only works or applies to the cubes rules only? No, it doesn't. As long as this number right here, if it's an odd number, okay? If it's an odd number, you can always take out the negative from the radical, just put it on the outside, and then just figure out the number. And that's the answer, okay? Thanks for watching.